Hey, hey, superstars, welcome week five. Week five. This week, we're going to do a little bit of a rehash, catch up. I know there's been a lot happening for everyone, and I love hearing all of your success stories, all of your thoughts, all of your concerns. And I'm really, really grateful for everyone jumping in and really giving everything a go consistently. And that's a few of the subjects we're going to go over today. So I'm going to share with you my screen, and we're going to go over a bit of a presentation on today's week five topics. How are you going with your wins today, guys? What have you found this week to be of benefit? What have you found of this week to be easier? Maybe you've found some challenges that you didn't know, or maybe you've found that certain thoughts and beliefs keep popping up that you can tell are really hindering your ability to succeed here. So this week here, I hope this little, it's going to be a short one, not too long, but we're going to go over some really great little tips and sheets that I think you guys are going to love. So please make sure you comment today below, once you've watched this, below the recording, and just give us your wins and your tweaklies. What are your tweaklies this week? What are we working on? What are the simple, tiny little things that we are working to achieve this week, building on top of our other tweaklies? So with our wins, when did you have the win? What did you do in order to actually have that win? What was the different action or the different sequence? Was it prepping? Was it doing a shopping list? Was it ensuring that your cupboards were empty, or ensuring that you had your shoes ready and your gym clothes ready to go? Or was it having someone to hold accountable to show up and go for the fitness or go for the thing or do the shopping? Was it communicating effectively with those around you, the team that you have that is your family and your network, in order to remain accountable and succeed in your goals? Have you had these wins before? Like, is this something you've been like, all right, I get to this point and I keep getting sabotage, or I get to this point and I fall off the bandwagon? If these are things that you've had wins before, let's have a look at what else is actually needed to get you past that. What are the small tweaks or the small awarenesses that we need to embed or ingrain or ensure are going to assist you in stepping forward with power and purpose and passion? I'm hoping after today's session, we can really hone in on that. Some really great topics here, and I'd love to hear all of your feedback all the way along. So the other thing is at this point, week five, has anyone else noticed the changes in you? Is there family members, is there friends, is there school teachers or kids or anything like, or partners that are noticing a difference in the person that you've become today through the small tweaklies and the wins that we've been having? Really hone in on that. What is it that they've noticed? What's everyone else's opinion of you at the moment? This will give you some really great feedback and potentially give you a little bit of knowledge that maybe you may not have come to realize on your own. And this is the great benefit of really leaning into the support network that we have, because obviously you go through your day-to-day rigmarole and you may not always actually understand or see or notice what you are or are not actually doing and how you are shifting and changing. So maybe reach out to those around you and just see, check in. Have you noticed any, reach out to your partner or your mom or your sister or someone like that and ask them, have you noticed any difference in me? What is it you've noticed? So today's topics that we're going to go over is consistency and discipline, strengthening your values and 10Xing your success. And we're just going to touch back on again, the reset your mindset. We're going to keep it relatively quick and simple, but I'm going to give you guys a couple of links and or PDFs that I would love for you guys to fill out and share with the group. Even if you take a photo, if you jot down below what you have put, what you've come up with from these activities, and just share them below with everyone, would be a really, really great community, great tribe thing to do, because I guarantee you it's going to share a little bit of motivation and inspiration for others. So this week, what I want to talk about a bit is peaks and plateaus. So what is a peak and a plateau? So a peak is when you reach the highest point, either at a specific value or at a specified time. So a peak is the highest point in which you could get to. So this is generally when we may set our goals. Our peak is, yes, I am on my way. I am achieving everything that I wanted to achieve. I'm smashing my goals. Everything feels amazing. But eventually, a peak can quite often get to a point where it drops off. And so understanding that there is always a yin and a yang, and this is why the last slide, the last conversation we just had a second ago, was talking on what are the changes you've made? What are the steps and the structure and the support that you've set for yourself in achieving these goals? Because these things are the really important parts. These are the things that are going to help you to elongate that peak and have it continuing to grow and continuing to expand and you succeeding and achieving those goals. But the other thing is remembering that once we reach a peak, sometimes we need to reset our target for a higher, greater level. And this is where plateaus come in. What is a plateau? An area of fairly level, high ground, a state of little or no change following a period of activity or progress. So you can see peaks and plateaus are actually very, very important and a natural part of this process. A plateau, as that says, a level high ground, means that generally it's a level field where you've gotten to that you've never probably gotten to before. So the body's gotten to a point where it's lost heaps of weight, or you've got lots of clarity, or you're feeling energized and great, and you're just sitting at this natural state. And generally the greatest part of this is the fact that you have two slopes either side of that, one leading up, one leading down. Our goal is to get you to the plateaus and celebrate the plateaus, because it means you're in a new state of leveling out that you've probably never been to before. It gives you a moment in time to catch your breath, reset, recalibrate, and get ready to achieve or set a new peak or a new goal at which you will be striving for. So we want to get to the peaks, but we would love the peaks to be followed by a plateau, because that gives you that, your body, that moment of rest and recovery or recalibration to reset yourself and go again. And that's what this week is really about, resetting and going again. So plateaus quite often are, people resent them because they feel like they've reached a stagnant point, but it's really just about recalibrating, resetting the sails, catching the wind and sailing off again in the highest direction. So our next topic I would like to discuss, or actually no, before we do that, can you guys share with me in the comments below, have you reached a peak or a plateau of late or in the past? And what happened to you? What's a past story? What's something that's come up for you in the past where you've experienced a peak or a plateau? I'd love for you to share with the group, what has that been like for you? Did you get a plateau that then toppled backwards at the end of it, because there was no structure and support to get through that point? Or did you reach a peak and again drop off the other side? Or did you manage to elongate this, and did you find a few tweaks and processes that assisted you in staying the course and continuing to grow and reach new goals and new potential? Please share with the group. Our next point of conversation is consistency and discipline. And I love giving you guys these points of context, because consistency is the way in which a substance holds together a thickness or viscosity. What is the consistency of choice of life or lifestyle that you're wanting to create? What is the viscosity? What is the substance that you're trying to hold together in your life? What part of your life are you trying to hold together and create a greater version of yourself? What is it that you are consistent? Let me rephrase that. Which consistency are you wishing to get to? But it's also really the consistent behavior or treatment that is achieving the goal. So you are consistently creating a thickness, which is a lifestyle. I would liken that statement to be, what is the consistency of lifestyle, the substance of lifestyle, the substance of living that you are wishing to obtain? And what is the behavior or treatment in which you're needing to obtain to create that and maintain that, and hopefully go beyond maintaining and actually consistently excel and grow and develop? Then the discipline is the practice of training people to obey rules or a code of behavior using punishment or correct disobedience. So it's a great way of putting it there, but what I'd like to reframe that into is understanding discipline is the practice of training yourself to understand your code and your behaviors, avoiding punishment. We actually want to know, well, what we get to understand here with PH360 is that there is no need for the punishment. It's more about understanding the codes of behavior that are specific to you, that are not like someone else's, that are specific to your DNA, that are going to enable you to create obedience of desires, obedience of actions, obedience of reactions, to get your goal and to continue to reach the consistency and the peaks and the plateaus that you want, so that you are consistently evolving and growing. Hence why this is self-evolution and beyond program. It's about training yourself to obey your rules and continuously growing, knowing that it takes consistency, knowing that it takes determination and discipline to continue to persevere in all aspects of your life. But please remember, No one gets this right all of the time. No one is consistently perfect. It is all about creating the contrast so that we are constantly searching and growing and desiring to reach newer levels of ourselves. But also, if everything was the same every single day, you would never actually really grow or push or strive for anything more, because you'd be in this state of existing, which we spoke about last week, right? On the group call. It's about understanding that contrast is a gift. Peaks and plateaus are gifts. They are points at which we get to re-reference our desires and check in on ourselves. It is okay to change daily your desires and your trajectory. It's fine to do that, because you are a human having this experience, and everything that comes into your awareness each and every day will give you new flavors, new substances, new consistencies of which you are existing and then desiring to move forward into other aspects of. I hope that makes sense. So I'd love to hear, what is the consistency and or disciplines in which you are employing this week to move forward and start to aim for your next peak and or plateau? Comment below. So when it comes to staying the course and consistently showing up for yourself, it's about really tapping into your core values. And a lot of us actually don't realize or don't actually fully know what our core values actually are, right? We just go about doing the thing. We do the do. But your success is actually hinged on understanding the values that you have and why on earth they matter to you. What do those values provide for you and with you? So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to give you all a PDF that's going to go through discussing one of the ones I found, why recreate the wheel when there's something perfect, right here. And this one is helping you define your core values, who you are, what you're striving for, looking at your mindset, and then finding your core values list. So I'd love for you guys to grab this and print it out, go through, fill it out, pick a photo of your note, and I'd love for you guys to post up what your core values are. What are they in your life right now? What is your primary way of being? What values are essential for you in supporting your inner self in this journey? Please, please, please get on board and share this one with the group. It's an incredible document. I'm going to pop it up inside of the, you'll see this above the recording in the verbiage above. So go through that one and have a good look. Have a good go with it. Please fill it out. Oh, sorry, wrong spot. This one. Please fill it out and share with the group, or take a photo. It's up to you. Or maybe you just want to jot it down and share your last statement. Let's go with that. I'd love for you to share your core values or your final statement. Now, back in week one, we went through reset your mindset, because honestly, 98% of the time, it is our mindset and our perception and our beliefs of which will either help us to continue to evolve, stagnate, or dwindle. It's our mindset that has the most pinnacle point of giving us everything that we need to push forward and succeed. So let's jump back in and quickly go over a reset your mindset. I will also have these posted above in the verbiage, but I would like for you to fill this one out. Let's have a look. Maybe you've still got your reset your mindset from the first week. If you do, grab that one out or go find it after this and just fill it in. Check back in and see whether they are still the same. So in 6 months, what was the result you would love to have? Is it, I would like to, and get specific, guys. You must get specific, or this will never actually really connect with your core values, with your core desires. It will just become another wishy-washy statement that you've written down and not achieved, that then leads to resentment and all these other heavy, horrible feelings. And I really want to help you guys to avoid that. So in 6 months, what was the result you would love to have? Is it, I would like to, and make sure it's a smart goal, nothing ridiculous. I'm not going to sit there and expect to be losing 20, 30 kilos in 6 months. I would sit there and say, in 6 months, I would like to have, this is my personal ones, I would like to have 4 kilos lost. I would like to have buns of steel. I would like to have my legs stronger than ever. I would like to increase all of my personal bests on my lifts, having my deadlift, my leg press, and my squats equal out, because at the moment they are terribly lopsided. In 6 months, I would like to be able to do 5 chin-ups without assistance. In 6 months, I would like to have the top part of my abdomen showing so that I have a bit of definition. I would love to have a lot more emotional intelligence and connection with myself so that I can show up for another in a way that I've never been able to before. In 6 months, I would like to know that I have the ability to choose the best version of myself, not just for myself, but for every single human that I come into contact with, and be able to speak vibrantly and clearly with all those that come into contact with me, so that I can serve out my purpose and my values as a leader, an empire, and someone who stands for the greatness of human capacity. Please share yours. But that kind of covers the next point, which is, what is your reasons for aiming for these goals? In your eyes, what are the main benefits associated with achieving them? I hope these kind of help you guys to nut this out. If you achieve in the next 6 months these goals, how will you feel? What decisions did you make to achieve them? So for me, it's getting my work done. I need to make sure that I'm having plenty of time to fill my own cup, but I'm also listing out what needs to be done. I'm being realistic with my time. I'm being kind to myself. I'm being motivated and driven. I'm ensuring that I'm eating effectively at the right time, matching with my chronobiology wheels in my PH360 app. I'm ensuring that I'm getting out my fitness every single day. I'm becoming more aware of my emotional reactions that I have with the life that I live, especially being a diplomat at nighttime, considering foods at nighttime. If I'm not emotionally in check, I find that I am emotionally eating at nighttime, which is something that diplomats quite often deal with. So I'm becoming very aware of that, and I'm taking a lot of note of that. I'm ensuring I don't have those things in front of me. I finish my dinner, I make a gigantic cup of herbal tea, and I leave the kitchen and do not return. what are the decisions to make that I'm going to honor my body every single step of the way? And if I fall off my decision bandwagon, I'm going to be kind to myself and be aware of what is happening around me to cause that reaction. And then I'm going to be okay with it. I'm not going to become the asshole to myself anymore. I'm going to allow myself to make my mistakes and move past them quickly. If you didn't achieve this in the next 6 months, I really, really want you to feel into this as much as you can. If you didn't achieve this in the next 6 months, you're still sitting in the same situation you are right now. You're still hating on yourself, or still negatively talking to yourself, or still blaming yourself and or others outside of a healthy balance. If you are still sitting there in 6 months' time and you have not chosen to go all in with this, you have not chosen to do this for yourself, your family, and the future that you're wanting to create, how will you feel? I know I would feel very frustrated, very sad. I would be feeling like I'd let myself down, like I'd let my purpose and my mission down. I would feel like I'd wasted my time, other people's time. I would feel horrendous. What decisions did I make? Would be not showing up for myself, not doing the work, not choosing to be in control of my choices and how I show up, not choosing to put myself first, and not choosing to be consistent. Please share with the group, because your reset your mindset is one of the most crucial components. Maybe draw out a picture of who you are and what you are creating. If you are someone who likes to have a vision board, maybe you might want to do one of those, guys. So if you're a vision board person, I kind of have one here. Just a few things, like a nice, I've got a few pictures of I've got Paris over here on the wall. I've got ships, I've got trips, I've got stuff written on a whiteboard here. Maybe you're someone who likes to do colorful things, or maybe you don't like vision boards and you want to do a vision box where you actually write down who you are, what you're wanting to achieve and what you're wanting to create. And maybe you do these sorts of things where you write them down, get them out of you, then put them out of sight, out of mind. If you guys remember the training we did on the vision box, all that is in this box is done. So I like to write them down, get them out of the way, know that I've set them free and I'm not attaching too much emotion to them. And then I get about my business. I write my lists. What do I need to do? Who do I need to be? How do I need to show up in order for myself so that I can show up for those around me and the mission that I'm here to create? We are all here. We are all incredible creators. Everything is within your power and is within your abilities. You just have to remember that it is your choices that make the cause and effect of how your life shows up for you. So just finishing out, I'm going to keep it, like I said, nice, short, sharp and shiny. Recapping on today, and I'm going to make sure all of this is in the content above. Summary, your wins. What wins have you had? What did you need to do differently to achieve these wins? Have you had these wins before? Did you notice any changes in you? Did others notice changes in you? The consistency and the discipline work. what is the consistent disciplines that you need to be achieving and structuring for yourself so that you can achieve your goals? What are your core values and how can you work towards 10xing your success by honoring and sticking to those more? Reset your mindset, go through the reset your mindset again and give us a little bit of a description. So basically you should be able to do this all in one sheet, one page, jot it all down, share it with the group, remain accountable, do the work, take the action and reap the rewards. Peace out, guys. I love you all. And I really cannot wait for the next call that we're on. All questions, thoughts, and concerns, voice them because I guarantee you, you are not alone. Thanks, guys. Have a wonderful week.